Hello everyone, welcome to day 21st of August LeetCode Challenge, and today's question is sort by parity. I hope you have gone through the question, and let's look at it by an example. So you are given an input array and you need to sort the array in such a way, first even elements appear and then followed by the odd elements. Here is a trick to solve this question. So what you're going to do is, you'll define a new array of the same size and you'll be using a two-pointer approach. The start pointer will be used to account for even elements and the end pointer will account for the odd elements. So what you're going to do is you'll iterate through this array, and if you see an even element, you'll add it to the starting position and update your start index, start pointer. And if you see an odd value, you will add it to the end of the list and reduce the end pointer. So let's iterate through an example. So you are at 0. So it's an even in nature, you added 0 here and you moved s to this position, and now comes 1, you added 1 at the end of it, end pointer, and end then move points to this position, and then comes 2, you added 2 here, you again incremented start pointer to this next position, and then comes 3, you added 3 here and reduce the end pointer to the previous position, and then came 4, you added 4 here and incremented to this position, and then comes 5, and 5 it's an odd number, and then you complete added this to the end of it, and since all the elements are traversed now, the sorting is done and you'll return this array. As this is given the algorithm, defining a new sorted array to hold the result, integer a dot length, defining two pointers start and end, which will be equal to a dot length minus 1, and let's iterate over the elements, the input array. If el modulus 2 equals to 0, then you'll be, this is an even case, you'll be adding it to the start index, sorted array, even at the start index equals to el start plus plus, else sorted array of end, because that's an odd case, el, and you'll reduce end by 1. And you simply return the array, sorted array. This should work. Let's try this up. In the meantime, let's discuss about the complexity. So the space complexity in this case is order of n, because you are creating a new array as that of the input array, and the time complexity is order of n, since you are traversing all the elements of the array at least once. So this looks good. Let's just sum it out. Yeah, it's done. Thanks for watching the video.